First of all, I would like to ask you about the art of managing different personality types in your team. Protagonists, superstars, how you manage to control them?
Well, it's a matter of experience, learning from different situations you have been through, different kind of personalities you have been dealing with. I would never use the word control. I will always use probably the word, help them to merge their efforts, their talents, their desire to win into, let's say, a unique direction. Just being all together in the same mission, in the same sincere commitment of putting the team first and your ego after.
Coach, do you agree that some people are born for a specific job? I mean, that seems that the coach of national team of Spain is the perfect place for you.
I don't really believe too much in, especially for coaches, in those levels. Flexibility and the capacity to adjust, to understand what is with you on that specific team is a great skill, in my opinion, for coaches. To be able really to understand what that team's needs and what it takes to help them to perform at their let's say, top level.
Let's talk about the crisis management, about unexpected events that probably threaten to harm the balance of the team. Probably we could speak about, let's say, the injury of Sergio Llull during that friendly game against Belgium.
The big concern which we always have is about our teammate. And I will never forget exactly when what you were mentioning, a friendly game against Belgium, when Sergio Llull got hurt. I will never forget the faces, the body language of his teammates from then on until the end of the game, which we lost at home, by the way. It was a friendly game, but I really, it was kind of a living a nightmare, living in a horror situation where nobody wanted to be there.
Personally, you have celebrated 7 medals with the national team, right, since 2009 from Eurobasket.
I don't even remember.
I think that 7 medals. Let's talk about this, about success management, and also about the motivation that you have to bring to the players from summer to summer.
This is an heritage which I inherited from people who were before me, and same for players. Players who are playing this team had the chance and were lucky enough to share locker room and bench and trips and rooms with the real legends of these sports, which taught them how to be a team player, what do you really need to do to be in this team, how to manage your own ego. The good thing is that this kind of values get passed on from a generation to the other one, and we try to do it also with the very young guys.
Let's talk about the luck factor. I guess that it was a really big advantage for you that you had the chance to work together with probably the most talented and blessed generation of the Spanish basketball, the generation of the 80s, with Pau, with Felipe, with Juan Carlos Navarro.
Well, luck is always a factor. I always consider luck when injuries don't happen. Then a train comes by, right? A car, whatever you want to call it. And if you are able to jump on it, you have been lucky enough, even much more difficult, be able to stay on it and not to get kicked out at the very first curve, because it's a very high-speed train. It's hard to jump on it. Sometimes people don't even see the train coming. They lose opportunity. You lucky to see those opportunity happen, and then you have to deserve that luck. Even going back to your example, you of course can be lucky enough to you know, have the chance to coach these players, but these players can decide to be coached from you or not. They decided that I was going to help them to win.
About your cooperation with the coaches of the youth teams, I guess that, I don't know if it's true or not, but we have learned that the youth teams of Spain play the same systems with the main team.
After many years of working in the same direction, we can say that we have built up a kind of a pyramid, but opposite pyramid, where, say, the under 12 is the little point at the bottom of the pyramid, and the main team is the, you know, huge line, the base, reverse base of the pyramid. And we try to add every generation something new, but on the same line. All coaches must adjust to the line we have decided. And there is a little merge for every team to do something different according to their specific skills of that generation, because then we compete, and we like to compete, of course. But the main part of what they do offensively and defensively is a part of a, let's say, manual which we prepare, we adjust, we change, like in many other initiatives we do, to make everybody feel part of the same family. I remember last summer we had every national team spend one day with the main team. They were watching practice. They were practicing the same place. They were having dinner, lunch together. The main thing in the national team where you don't get money to play, it is to feel proud of being part of one of the probably most legendary institutions of the whole sports.
I would like to ask you, from all these successes, from all these medals, which tournament, personally, was the biggest challenge for you? Which was the biggest crisis that you had to face all these years? And which success you consider as the most important?
I would say the first one, in 2009, when I took over, there was a really high level of pressure because Spain had never won a European championship before. And it was really kind of a feeling that something was missing and that something had to happen to be considered really one of the top national team in the world. We started in a tough way with many injuries, with Pau Gasol getting injured in the first day of the training camp, then not being able to practice until the very first game of the competition, playing probably his worst game ever. There were many different challenging situations which could have disrupted the unity and the togetherness of the team. We ended up, doing a great job, especially from, you know, quarterfinals on. And it was a great championship because we beat everybody by 20 from then on. I mean, it was one of the strengths demonstration probably more remarkable that I can recall. We never put a limit to our possibilities, to our ambition. And probably the worst moment was, I would say, well, probably the only time when we didn't win a medal in 2010 in the World Championship in Turkey. We were winning by one in the very last second against Serbia in quarterfinal, and then Teodosic hit a crazy long distance 3-point shot, and they beat us.
Is there any specific game against Greece that you remember most?
In 2009, starting 2009, it was a really, really tough semifinal we played against them, it ended up in the right way, but it was really tough. They were really good. I don't remember I don't remember losses in 2015, for example, in France. They were, you know, strong. Like that year, for example, they had a really, really good team. Last appearances of Spanoulis and Giannis coming up. But there were always great games. Most of them were close games. But I have great respect for Greek basketball and looking forward to play a game. Hopefully, one of the last stages of the next championship, of Olympic Games.
I would like to ask you also about the game that you would like to coach again, but I don't know if you... I guess that it would be the final of the Olympic Games against USA.
And if it's not against US, I don't care. I mean, I don't mind. If it's against another team, that's going to be good too.